Psychics for this evening. The wonderful Sunny Park, who I'm going to hand this microphone. Her twin in all things, Sunny Park.
Hello, everybody. I like to call them my hecklers. Patty Negri. She's a very good bitch. Michelle Gilhouse. And the wonderful Legina Smith. Girls, it's so fun to have you all here. Who should I give the second microphone to? Okay, I'm Sheena. If you need anything, come and find me. I'll be waiting for the aliens to come and get me in my big hot pink polka dot shirt. Okay, hi everybody. Thank you so much for coming. I am Patty, and I've been the one who's been elected to lift the veil so all the spirits can come in. You guys ready for that? So we want you to open your ears and your eyes and your mind and your third eye so we can tune in. So everybody, just because it's crazy and we're in the middle of Hollywood, everybody, you don't have to stop. You don't really have to close your eyes, but just everybody take a nice, beautiful, deep breath for a second. And exhale. And I want to see us with a great big blanket of light just coming down like the tent on top of this building, just drifting down like the beautiful fog over everybody here. Pure white light, pure divinity, pure possibility as we open up the veil. I personally work elemental. Yes, I'm a witch. I'm a good witch. So I want to call in elements, which is just the air, the wind, and the fire. So as we get started, I want to call in the guardians of the watchtowers of the East, which is the powers of air. Air is our intellect, it's our thinking process, it's our sense of organization. So let's let a big, beautiful wind blow in. Number one, it'll cool us off, and number two, it'll help open our hearing to everything. Now I want to call on the guardians of the watchtowers of the South, which is the fire, which is passion and creativity and love and all those good things. So everybody wants to put a little fire, so feel it in the base of your spine, rising and rising, to burn away any fear, burn away any doubt, just to open it up for all the spirits of the fire to come in with us now. Now I want to call in the guardians of the watchtowers of the West, the beautiful water, beautiful, sweet, clear water to wash through this space, again, wash away fear and doubt and confusion, and bring in sweet, clear messages to all the women on this stage, the other beautiful psychics we have that's going to be doing readings with us afterwards, and to each of you here. And last but not least, I want to call on the guardians of the watchtowers of the North. That's our beautiful Mother Earth herself. That will keep us grounded and keep us safe and keep us clear in our thinking with what we're doing. So right now, picture a great big swirl, swirl, swirl within this space. Energy, energy, and as that beautiful veil... As that beautiful veil is lifting, 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 I call in each of your divinity. If whatever you work with, if you work with angels or spirit guides or aliens or Jesus, I invite them in right now. And we bring in only light and love and good messages that we just may be conduits for good and light and helpful information for each of you. So mote it be. All right. You want to explain how we're doing this? Okay, and you can tell we're really prepared for this. You guys, thank you for your patience. I want to say I know service is a little rough. They weren't quite expecting this crowd. Not all of you RSVP'd. Their waitress's father had a heart attack. We're short one staff. But we're going to just start our reading. So be open. If there's somebody you want to talk to, put them in your head, invite them in, and we're going to just go down the line, right?
Diamond ring. There you go.
Can you hear me? Come to the light, come to the light. They can't see you, they can't hear you.
Can you get a little bit closer? Hold to a little bit closer.
Only if you hold the mic really close to your mouth.
I'm kissing it. Can you hear me?
Is it on? Is it on? Is it on?
I think you should bring her with you to the light. You don't want to start, we've got her up here, so do you want to start it? Okay.
It doesn't always feel like you're meaning like
can't hear you.
You can't hear me? I definitely feel like this person is a sensitive, meaning that she can absorb emotions, correct? And I feel a sensitivity with a male figure as a father. And I felt like there was some, like anxiety kind of, but you take it on as if it's your own, as if you lived it, you know what I mean? As if you're punishing yourself for anxiety purposes, you know what I'm saying? But you act him out without knowing, you understand? Because he has the anxiety. So I kind of had this message like from a father figure saying, she's taking me on. She keeps acting me out. So I want you to lift it off of you. That's what I'm saying. Because it's not you, okay? He's the one that is guilty and feeling bad and not feeling good about himself. So why should you? You're so beautiful. You have so much to give, you know? So that emotion, that layer, take it off.
I'm also picking. Can you hear me? Okay.
Yes.
The first thing I started picking up on was panic attack. Like a lot of anxiety here, and it's like your heart, just really beats really fast, and then you're overwhelmed, and you don't know exactly why, because nothing has triggered you, nothing has happened, but all of a sudden it's just this huge panic attack, and that is coinciding with what he is saying, is that you're definitely picking
sorry,
up on your
cables.
Daughter, and those guys are not like,
bye. Sorry, I'm the bad twin.
So it's definitely not you, it is you picking up on him, and even though you guys are not close, there is still that genetic connection, which will manifest itself. And it's like I feel like the more you open up to yourself, and the more you're aware of your own abilities, the more you'll be able to separate, you know, your energy from your dad. Even though you guys are connected,
I think we're
gonna
get rid of the wireless and just go
to cleanse your energy and make boundaries. Not only from your father, but from other people around you who perhaps are taking from you without.
Try just the one with the wire, if you don't mind.
And I'm definitely getting a sense that you're very, very intuitive. And you have a sense of knowing this, and wherever you go, I just.
Oh.
Is it this one?
No, I think it's this one. It can't be by that.
But definitely, you're being encouraged to pursue your spiritual gifts, to make a connection with our meditation and seek out on all wills. There are your energies of setting boundaries.
Oh, are we moving on? Or did you have something for her? No. All right. Thank you very much. Thank you. Yay. All right. I've got actually two things. So I don't. One I might save for later. Is there a Sam? Somebody has somebody deceased named Sam. Does somebody have somebody? I don't know if it's a father or an uncle here. Somebody back here. Okay. Sam is here. Sam was like doing exactly what you're doing, Roz. Going, hey, hey, hey. Just wanted to say hi. I've never even met anybody named Sam before. And something about Australian, does that mean something to you? An Australian word of some sort? Not average, billabong, I don't know. Do you want to come up, Ross? Come on up. Anyways, Sam, also an intuitive, beautiful Ross. No, Sam came in right away. And he wanted to talk to you. And I don't know, is somebody that you used to do something with a long time ago with a play with words of some sort? You have a friend in, okay, maybe he wants you to talk to your friend in Australia there, because it was very, very clearly Sam about Australia, not that they knew each other.
David is a medium and he's in Australia.
Okay, and Sam is?
My recently deceased father.
Ah, did Sam know your friend in Australia?
He doesn't even know me, I've never met him.
Okay, well he's talking about him right now, so I think that's something for you to go do. So anyway, thank you very much. Okay, bye, Sam. Hi. All right, everybody ready?
Hello. What's your name?
Chow.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Okay. Is that better?
Yeah.
Okay. You can. Sure, come on.
We can do psychic readings, but we can't do mics.
Okay. Come to the one. Hi. I feel very drawn to you. I feel like you have a lot of things coming to you in 2016 that need to come through. I feel like a lot of negativity is being cleared from you right now that needs to be cleared. I feel like you're stuck on one particular thing though. There's definitely some people in your lives that needs to go, and I think you know this, but you're trying to figure out a way to kind of do that and kind of attach in those cords. Once you do that, I feel like you're gonna take off. I feel like your light is kind of dim right now. You know, you're very low energy. But I feel like, you know, it's from all the things you've kind of been through recently. I feel a lot of different emotions, a lot of sadness and anger. So much anger. You're so mad. You know, you want to just, you want things to just be clear and things to be good again. But I feel like in 2016, I feel like that's just going to be a year for you to kind of just new beginnings. I feel like that's a time for you to start over and get back to you. So just make a plan and stay on track with that, because I feel like whatever you want to do, you're going to be able to do it. Manifest it and you will have it. But make sure to leave all that toxic energy away from you, because you don't need it.
And I know that there's an unborn child in the mix was part of your angst, and it just wasn't time for that child, and that child is coming in. So don't worry. That is, let go of that is the anger she was talking about and the angst she was talking about. It just wasn't time for the child, but the child will come at the right time. Okay? Thank you, Cha.
She has something to
say. Your family? Your husband? You have twins? Because I saw twins. In the future. Yeah, get another job.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Okay.
No, not exactly. Well, I am picking up on, and this can apply to a lot of people, but I'm definitely picking up on some lower abdomen issues. I feel like it's not exactly digestive. I want to say that it's reproductive, so it's definitely related to a female. And I even want to say it has to do with endometriosis, because I'm getting a visual of tissue. Is this, again, I'm getting a big thing of endometriosis. Okay. And whomever this might
come on up! It's, psychic is right!
Okay. Because what the message related to love
was... Do you
have
endometriosis?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, now everyone knows.
I feel like this condition is, it's stress related and it's spiritual. And you know, like with the endometriosis, the tissue kind of binds to the uterus, and it feels as though you have some emotional stress or some past things that have stuck around that is manifesting through this condition. And it feels as though, like, you really need to start doing a lot of releasing people in particular. I feel like there's family members in your life that are weighing you down. And I feel like You also have very magical, very healer energy. And I feel like once you can cut out those toxic people, once you focus in on it, you're going to find your symptoms are going to reduce significantly. And you're going to have a lot less pain. Okay.
Ankle.
What did you do to it? Are you like that clumsy?
I was crying and happy and I fell down the flight of stairs. Cause I was so happy and I grabbed it last.
I feel like it hasn't healed yet. Like you've totally neglected it. You are so bad. Because I feel like I've got a broken leg now.
I worked on it 2 weeks after I broke it.
Oh, that's nice. Okay.
Well,
so it's between like the foot not healing, you're going to pick up on people's emotions. Like if you're not physically well, all of a sudden every negative thought and negative emotion is going to come onto you as if it's like a piece of clothing. Like you're wearing it all day. So on top of like your foot or your ankle, then you're going to feel everybody else's feet and ankles and knees, and you're just going to be one walking hot mess, you know? So you might want to heal that, you know, like make sure you stretch it. Make sure you know, you got to take care of you. So that's my message. Bad ankle. Bad.
Just take some extra marijuana.
Thank you.
I'm feeling someone has a male that was in a car accident or some type of accident. I would say it's over here. Come on, look.
Hi there.
Hi. You had a male that was in a car accident? Okay.
Yes. I'm used to watching my medium, so I'm not supposed to say anything. Wait for you to tell me. a cousin.
Was he like father?
I'm getting a father figure. Like he was like he loved you. Like, in a sense.
You gotta be careful with the cable.
Okay. Oh, okay.
I'm getting...
Yeah, it was the father figure, so... Is your friend here? Yes. Oh, okay.
I mean, she's present in the earth.
Well, he's here. And who is the other guy that you were talking about? Your cousin? He's probably with him, too, but that's the one I got, was the father. That's weird. Well, maybe you were just supposed to come here for that, just for... He's so cute. Aw.
I don't.
You have somebody that you've lost, somebody used to have a really special blue shirt, huh? Do you remember him having a blue shirt? I'm seeing somebody came in with a blue shirt. No? Don't know. Mark? Okay, well, I'm seeing somebody, an older male figure with a blue shirt. But this could be it could be a grandfather or something like that, or an uncle. But this could be a fatherish figure.
Once.
Okay, but is there another older man that you know passed away?
Yeah.
Okay, that's who's coming in here. Do you ever remember showing me himself in a blue shirt, and he thought you should know that. You don't remember a blue shirt?
No.
Okay, what's his name?
Maybe my papa.
Yeah, I think it's your papa. That's like a father figure, but it's a grandpa, right? Okay. He's really, really proud of you. And he does think you should remember his blue shirt because you spilled something on it once. You spilled something on it once, and he didn't get mad at you, but you got kind of scared. So maybe that's why you've blocked it out. But he just really, really loves you. And he wanted to know. That's the father figure she was getting, okay?
Maybe it's barf.
Did you barf on it? Maybe it's barf. He said you should remember. Maybe it's coming back to you now. That did happen. Okay, so there you go. All right. He loves you very much, and he's going to watch over you, okay? All right. Thank you.
I feel like she's like of a guardian to you. I feel like it's a grandmother, maybe a great-grandmother or something of this sort. I feel like she's around you a lot. She's been around you since you've been a little girl. And she follows you, she protects you. She's showing me a bike, a red bike, of some sort, tricycle or something from when you were little or something like that. She's talking about your tricycle. Her favorite bike, she keeps showing me that tricycle. And she just keeps showing... her arms around you, so she's around you a lot. So she's, yeah, she's always with you. She's always with you. She's always doing things. I feel like she's always doing things with your hair for some reason. She likes to kind of pet your hair. And she likes to think about the old times. So she's always with you, and you can always talk to her. She hears you. So I just wanted to let you know that, okay?
What's your name?
Alyssa.
Do you know, like, you're a mini sponge for people's emotions too? That when you go into, you're gonna go into the arts. I saw you. I saw you being very creative. I'm now a puppet. I saw you being really creative. I saw you almost being like an artist psychologist, because you help so many people. You look 12, and you're not. You act like an older lady, but you have like an older lady's spirit in you. So what happened? Like, why are you so much like serious? You know what I mean? You have an old soul.
Like a kid.
No, I feel like really mature vibes from you, and you listen to people. You're a loyal friend. You're just very good to people. Like, you're so kind. It's almost like you're too kind. You know what I mean? So you kind of got to like reserve your energy a little bit, and that's all I'm saying. So when you get into college or when you start getting around a lot of people, don't be so nice. You got to get your bitch back. How old are you?
19.
Oh, okay.
Didn't you look 12?
Yeah, you look 12. Do you have there's a male I'm picking up around you that likes you? But you're kind of shy around guys, right? Well, he's even shyer. So I believe it's someone that you know, but you probably only look at him as a friend. He's definitely shy. He's in the background, brownish hair. Okay, well, you're going to marry him.
Wow. But don't rush into things. Wow.
Brown eyes. Oh, sorry, brown eyes. He's shy. He's gonna get cuter when he gets older. You'll find out.
Okay, you had a question? No. Oh, you just wanted somebody to tune in to you. Okay, everybody look at this person over here, the friend. I don't have anybody for you yet, but there's somebody named Bill here. Somebody has somebody named Bill who is very much an outdoorsman, not a city guy at all. That ringing a bell to anybody? Is he just passing through? Bill, William, Billy? No? Okay, speak up or forever hold your dead people. Okay, he just might be passing through. There's a whole lot of other people here. So, okay, if you think of it later, and it was for you, he's here. Okay. Anybody got something?
Sorry, I was immediately drawn to you. Yes. I'm picking up on a child figure, like someone that you mentored, someone that you mothered in a sense of a form that I'm trying to figure out maybe if they are in this realm or in the has passed over. And it's cloudy, to be honest. This person might be sick. But I do have a strong feeling that you, okay, they have, it's really unclear whether they're here or they're not. But I do definitely get a male figure who you mentored or whom you loved as a child. Someone I feel like you had a very protective vibe over them. And I feel like that this person perhaps didn't have a lot of support and that you stepped up in some way, shape, or form. Is this making any sense? Okay. If it doesn't make sense right now, it might make sense later. But it could be somewhere in this area as well. But I'm definitely getting a sense of somebody who has passed over or is sick or is kind of in between. Might be even in a coma. Is that
why couldn't you validate, Terry?
What?
Her husband. Yeah, keep talking about.
Oh.
I'm glad
you validated
for you.
Into the rest of the room.
The aliens got to you.
All right. I'm used to doing this for other people. I'm used to the one talking to the
dead. See, you've helped me. This woman's helped me so much, and I'm just, I'm like, over here somewhere, but it's... Yeah, somebody, is it her husband? Because I'm getting a very mentorish feeling that someone who's in between, someone who's in a coma and is not quite there making the full transition in from this realm into the next. And it feels as though that he is very much in spirit still everywhere, like, you know, in consciousness, as you and I know. And, I'm getting a huge feeling like there was a lot of mothering and a lot of nurturing and a lot of loving and caring. I even am seeing like, you know, like bathing with that towel and doing this thing. And it feels like it's just coming through as a strong thank you. I am here and I'm conscious and I love you.
Can I just ask, is there a Margaret? Somebody that has a Margaret? Margaret. Margaret was just, I was sitting there and Regina said, if anything comes to mind, it's like, Margaret's coming through. Multiple Margarets. First thing she wants me to tell you is not to be sad. She's telling me she's okay and she's having a lot of fun. No, but it just, there's something, it was like, there's something about, her departure, something about around when she passed, and it was difficult. And she said that she didn't want you to be sad. She wants you to remember her. Remember the things about her that she would have liked to have done and didn't do. Does that make sense? She's telling me she's really happy and she's feeling no pain and she's doing really well. And she does watch over you. Yeah, because she says you need it sometimes. You don't think you do, but you do. Is there anything you want to ask Margaret? Yeah. She's telling me something about a drawer. Something that was in a drawer. Something that was put away. Something that's. It was there something that she had that was in a drawer? It's like something like, I don't know, like a scarf or a handkerchief or something of hers that was in a drawer and she wanted you to have that. I don't know where, what that means.
Okay. I'll think on it. I don't know.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, Karen.
Thank you.
I'm picking up on someone who is just like on a roller coaster ride with a guy. It's a girl. It's a female. Shut up. Say she's in her 20s.
You're not 20.
Ariana, come here. I know it's you. Get over here. Shoshana, Ariana, Vabana, come on. No, Ariana. Did you just break up with someone or you're distant with someone? You're not consistent with someone?
Yeah.
Is he the music guy?
Yeah.
Okay. It's not like you, it's driving you nuts, right?
Yes.
Don't stop drinking so much. You were on a good health kick, weren't you? And then what happened? You went down the tubes because of this guy. What?
Whoa! That's a song.
Wow!
I'm sorry, I called you up. I think it's a circuit breaker.
Yep.
I'm scared to talk to you now.
Is he have brown hair like he's a bad boy? But he's really sensitive?
Yeah.
I think he's really, like, he's like your twin flame. You're totally foobar because of that.
But you have to wait for him.
Okay.
But act like you're not waiting.
Okay.
Okay? You gotta pull back. Stop stalking his pages or whatever you're doing. Driving, walking by his place. I don't know, but you're... Okay, but you're doing something to stalk. Okay, you gotta get off of the page because he can feel your energy is right on him. All I can see is you being on Facebook or wherever and just like going, oh my God, I wanna be with him, you know, but you will, you just gotta wait. You gotta act like you're not waiting, but be like, pull away, stop with the like that's like when you're in school and someone's over your shoulder while you're taking a test. It's like, get away from me, teacher. I can feel your breath on me. That's what you're doing, so you can feel it. Okay? So, that's your twin flame, but you have to wait. And look hot. Start eating good and being like, when he comes back, I'm going to be hot.
Okay.
Yeah, and like I said, I did feel the distance, but I also saw you. Where is he in New York? Because I see you going over there. What?
that's my city.
Yeah.
You're going to be going over there in the future. Not like tomorrow, but you're definitely going to be based there. Just letting you know.
Okay, I have a real fast one that's probably not going to go anywhere because we probably can't talk about it here. But somebody called Booby, and they're talking about their booby, and it's really cute and it's really sweet. Again, if
it's a pet name. Yeah.
It's a pet name. Oh, you're the one with the booby.
I have two friends that we all call each other.
Okay, that's hysterical. Well, you have somebody in spirit who's going booby, hey booby. So they're catching you up right now. That's hysterical. So I'm like, should I say this out here? We have children in the room. So yay, hi booby. Everybody say hi booby. Hi booby.
I just keep picking up on you dancing. I keep getting a lot of salsa or Zumba dancing with you. I just see you kind of dancing. I guess you're going to be dancing through life or something. I feel some celebrating, things to be rejoicing. I also feel like there's going to be some type of trip with you and your girlfriend. I don't know. I feel like somebody's getting divorced, but it's going to be one heck of a divorce trip. And you guys are going to get your groove on all in that trip. And you're just going to enjoy yourself. So enjoy that. I just see you doing lots of dancing, lots of hair flipping. I just see all of that, all this fun.
Yeah.
I'm sorry?
I got a divorce.
Oh, you got?
Yeah.
Oh!
Yes.
So let me tell you, from here on out, you're going to be good. You're going to be dancing through life. And I do feel like you're going to have someone new that's going to come in that you're going to be with. It's going to be at a good time when you're ready for it. So, but I feel like you're going to enjoy yourself for a while.
She's ready.
Yeah. She does. But I feel like lots of dancing. So really good.
Very good that you stepped away from that, because I feel like the ex was really oppressive, very controlling, and it came from an insecure place. And really good that you stepped away from that, because for me, it feels like that was a huge break for you, and that's going to bring you into a lot of happiness and a lot of good fortune, just everything kind of being like synchronistic, you know, like you go somewhere and just everything just falls into place. So good for you for having the ball, for having the
strength.
Yes, the strength. Thank you. For having the strength to do that, because that took a lot of bravery on your part. Thank you.
Go ahead, shy one.
Yeah. No, I was. They pretty much confirmed. I was going to say the same thing, but I feel like someone over here is going to have twins too. Right there.
Yeah, right over there.
That's right.
Out this direction.
My finger's going there. Curving.
Curving over there.
Did you hear me? Twins.
Oh yeah, we heard you. Yeah, we heard you.
You in the back, right there with the, I don't know what that is on your shirt there, I can't tell. Can you come up for me? Hi. Hi. What's your name?
Sherry.
I feel a lot of different energies with you. A lot of different, I'm feeling a lot of tension, I'm feeling sadness, I'm feeling anger and rage, I'm feeling all of that all at once from you. A lot of things going on with your family, a lot of things going on there. I feel a lot of bad blood with Dad, perhaps. I feel a lot of bad things there. So much negativity. I feel like he is a dangerous person. He's a dangerous man, and I know that you know this. Very dangerous. With your mom, Is it your mother? Is she in spirit? Yeah, your father, he definitely, he was the reason for her departure. He's the one that hurt her. Why did you cry? But mom wants you to know it's okay. She knows that you know what really went down with that situation, and she wants you to really let go of all of that so you can move on and live a healthy life. You know that she is okay. I feel like she likes to sing, or she likes music. She likes to something with the arts. I just feel mom was so creative, and you have a whole lot of that in you. Yeah, is that correct? Your mom, is she more creative, or? Yes, but mom, she's definitely with you all the time, and she's proud of you. She knows that you're gonna do big things, but she says do not dwell on the negative. Let go of anything that's holding you back. Don't feel stuck. There's nothing holding you back. I feel like the sky is the limit for you. You know, don't let that situation dictate the rest of your life. Okay, so the best thing you can do to make her proud is to move on and not let it affect you. Don't let him bring you down to take your power like he took hers. So, okay? Keep that in mind.
Up with you is that, like, I see you as, like, very not commanding, but like you're gonna be organizing and being like a leader of some of a huge, like, whether it be a huge company, whether it be a organization, I feel that you are in command. Okay, it's almost like you respect and love yourself so much that you need to express that to help other people that are not so loving for themselves. I even see charity with you. I see you're such a good guy. Like, I feel you have like this desire to change the world in some ways. Is that true?
It is. Started the company after anthropology.
Awesome. Okay. You're gonna be healing people like with that, and something is like coming through you, like a channel. Like a spirit guide is coming through you saying, do it now. Like, you know what I mean? And it's timing. And I feel you're gonna have like a couple of good people backing you up as well, financially. And they're, is that true?
Yes.
So I saw it, like, no wonder I came over to you. You're gonna be rich. Okay. I just felt you're not doing this for money, though. That's the thing. You're doing it because you're passionate and you have something to say, you know? So I feel like you're going to be healing, like kind of like how Bruce Jenner's paving the way, you know? You're going to be paving the way for people, and you're going to be healing so many on a global level. It's not going to be local. It's going to be global. Other languages, too.
Thank you.
You're not going to turn into a woman, right? You're not going to turn into a woman, right?
No, I wasn't meaning that way.
Do you have a sister? Okay, which one looks exactly like you? Does the younger one? I'm picking up on the one that looks exactly like you.
I feel like do you think she's in a depression? Like, she kind of has some, she's very fond of you, but I feel like there's something with her, you pick up on her. She has some kind of depression going on. There's something, an issue she has. And I feel like you're so sensitive to her, you pick up on her a lot.
even if you don't talk to her, you're gonna feel her. So do you ever feel those like sensitive, like very sensitive down days? You're picking up on her. So perhaps I'm bringing up her up so you can reach out to her or connect, because I feel like she needs you.
All right, so, and this.
We look constipated, we have to say a message.
That's true. I'm feeling in this area, someone is dealing with major low back pain. I'm feeling it like right. Really bad. I'm feeling it like right in this area, in the hips, in the lower spine. Almost debilitating, where like there's
two.
Okay. Very debilitating, where it's hard to get out. I'm also picking up on some nervous energy. They're even showing me lungs. Like it's like almost hard to breathe because of the nervousness of the anxiety. Okay. But whatever that, okay, let me just see if that can give me a little bit more clarification, because it definitely has to do with the nervousness, with the low back and feeling of pressure around the chest and in more in towards the rib cage area. And in addition to that, it feels as though it's incredibly debilitating, and it feels as though that there's a doctor that is going to be able to help, because I do definitely get a lung feeling, whether you know it or not, I don't know who it is yet. But I do get a really big feeling that there is a doctor about to come in and help bring clarity into the situation, because it feels as though the low back hip issues haven't been properly addressed. They're saying, like, I'm getting, like, people are saying it's fused spines, whatever it is, but I do get a feeling that there is going to be a doctor who's going to be able to bring clarification into the situation and be able to properly treat you. So don't give up hope, because I know it's weighing heavily, especially with me, when you're physically disabled, for lack of a better word. But don't give up hope, and it's gonna turn out all right. You're gonna get your diagnosis and you're gonna get your treatment, and everything's gonna be okay, and you'll be able to bounce right back into life.
To be honest, there's CBD for that major pain.
Right over there.
We only have a couple more minutes, I think, so send your spirits over if anybody hasn't got an ask yet. I keep hearing, go over there, somebody, there's a, it sounds like Sue or Susan or Sue passed over. Somebody wants to talk to somebody. Does that ring somebody over there? A Sue? Okay. Where? Over there. Okay. Showing me a blanket. Does that mean something to you? Yes. Okay. Do you want to come in? Okay. Yeah, Sue's been talking for a little while. Come on up. What's your name?
Sarah.
Hi, Sarah. What she's saying is, remember who you are. Does that mean something to you?
Sure.
Okay. Well, she says, it should mean something to you, that there's a little piece of you, that you're kind of hiding away right now, to yourself, to the world out there. And she wants to literally shake you on the shoulders and like that. Sarah, does that sort of make sense?
Yeah.
Okay, and the blanket means something to you. It's almost like it's... Okay, she, what's the blanket?
She made me a blanket, or of a... T-shirts from my company that I had. She was making a quilt.
All right. Well, give her a big hug. She loves you so much, and she just wanted you to know that she is here. And she said, if you don't know what she's talking about, that let that little part of yourself out again. That you didn't know. Okay. Okay. Thank you very much. She just loves you. She is there for you. She will talk to you in dream time. If you want dream time, come.
Like, no, I'm next.
Me too. Okay. I'm next. Thank you very much.
Guys, it's sad we have to say goodbye. The gallery is now over with, so we really appreciate everyone watching us for an hour, and I don't think any aliens showed up, though. Sheena, what the hell?
What?
You're still here. If you have not gotten, if you want a private reading, Bettina here, who is owner of ESPsychics.com with my sister and I. Wow. She is basically taking everybody and putting them in our envelopes so we know who we're reading. And the readings will be over there to the left and over here to the right. So, hey, move out of the way. Just kidding.
What we're going to do is have everybody kind of in that area. If you could kind of come mingle and hang out here, all the readers will have their name on the table, and you can just kind of walk over with your ticket, and there's a basic timing, but on it kind of says what number you are in line. So give us a couple minutes. We're going to just grab these tables and put this up, and we're good to go.
And one more real quick. For those of you who aren't getting reading, or you're waiting for your reading, or you're with people who are getting reading, you're not, or you just want to hang out and talk, the kitchen is still open until 9 o'clock, so stay, have a drink, have dessert, and just stay over to this side of the room as the readers are going on over here.
And for all of you sensitives who have anxiety, there's, like, really good herbal stuff that is over here. Her name is Nicole. It's called CBD. It is so awesome. I actually use it. Okay, so check her out. She'll give you details. Do you want to talk? What? You never want to talk. You come up here.
So drawn to you because I feel like you're going to end up doing something. I feel a new business for you down the line that you're going to be doing. It's going to take off ridiculous for you. I feel like you're going to kind of be blasé about it and not really take it that seriously, but then I feel like it's going to just pop. And it's going to be good for you financially. So just stick with it and keep faith in it is what I have to tell you with that message, okay? Don't give up on it. It's going to be good for you. It's going to be good, okay? I saw money signs. I saw money signs for you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so really good for you. Yeah.
Yeah. We need more money for twins.
All right, you guys, let's give yourselves a plug. You've been a great audience. Thank you very much. We are ES Psychics, Patty Negri, Michelle Gillihouse, Soonhee Park, Chinhee Park, Legina Smith, and the beautiful Bettina. So again, hang out, drink, eat, be merry. People with readings will be in these two sections over here. Thank you and good night. Bye.